experiment of movement of inertia of given bodies using inertia table. Code is 55793. The apparatus which is required for the experiment is digital stop clock. Digital stop clock consists of a start and a reset button. Start button by the means of toggle switch. After that, inertia table. Inertia table consists of an aluminium disc which consists of a mirror which is suspended by a steel wire. The aluminium disc is of 15 cm and it is suspended by two rods. And a spirit level of 40 cm. Cylindrical metal bodies. Vernier caliper of 150 mm. And unknown metal bodies. Now we will perform the experiment. Experiment 1 is to determine the moment of inertia of a given body using the inertia table. This inertia table is consist of a circular table which having three screws, level screws S1, S2 and S3. Now we will measure the radius of solid body with the help of vernier caliper. Now we will use the cylindrical solid metal in such a manner. The main scale reading is 2.5, the vernier scale reading is 6 and the least count is 0.01 cm. So the radius is 0.0178 meter. Now we will calculate the moment of inertia, which is mr square by 2, where mass of cylinder is 100 gram, radius is 0.0178 meter divided by 2. So the moment of inertia is 0.144 into 10 raised to the power minus 4. Now we have to reset and start through the digital clock. First of all, we have to twist this and then reset and then start. Then calculate the oscillation. Like we have made a mark over here. So we have to calculate the oscillation in such a manner. Like 1 oscillation, 2nd oscillation, 3rd oscillation, 4th oscillation, 5th oscillation, 6th oscillation. So in this manner, we have to calculate the 20 oscillations and check the time in seconds. So after 20 oscillations, our time is 58 seconds. So now we will repeat the procedure with the help of these rings. So we will place these rings in such a manner. Then restart the button and start the button. So again the timer will be started and we will take the 20 oscillations and check the time, that how many times the 20 oscillations have been done. So after 20 oscillations the time is 60 seconds. Now we will perform the third step by placing the solid cylinder over here in such a manner so that this arrangement is in one thing, like these two are perpendicular to each other. So again the same procedure is done. We have to reset, then start, and then again count the oscillation in such a manner, like 1 oscillation, 2nd oscillation and 3rd oscillation. For 20 in this manner we will calculate till 20 oscillations and check the time. So now for the 20 oscillation the time is 63.2 seconds. Now we will perform the calculation. Now for the determination of periodic times, number of oscillation is 20, time of oscillation for inertia table is 58, auxiliary body is 63 and body of unknown moment of inertia is 61. So we can perform this experiment with the 30 oscillations and 40 oscillations also. So the average value for table T is equal to 58 seconds, T1 is equal to 61 seconds and T2 is equals to 63 seconds. So by the formula of I2, T2 square minus T square divided by T1 square minus T square into I1. Now we will calculate the value of I2 as T2, T, T1, I1 is given. So I2 is 0.7 into 10 raised to the power minus 5 kg into meter square. Hence, the moment of inertia of given body by inertia table is 0.7 into 10 raised to the power minus 5 kg into meter square.
Now, the another experiment is to study perpendicular axis theorem of moment of inertia with the solid.
Now, we will place this spirit level between S1 and S2 and check this bubble is coming between or not. So, in this manner, we will calculate between S2, S3, S3, S1. The solid body consists of X plane, Y plane and Z plane.
Now, we will perform the experiment. This experiment step is similar to the experiment 1. So, first we have to twist this, then reset, then stop. So, first of all, we will do the 20 oscillation and check time. After that, we will place the solid body and the unknown body on this and check the oscillations and time. So, after 15 oscillations, the time is 59 seconds. So, now we will place these solids. And place this solid body along x-axis. And further check the oscillation. So, after 15 oscillations, the time is 55 seconds. So along x-axis, time is 55 seconds. So, the same procedure is repeated for y-axis and for z-axis.
Now, we will make the observation table, which consists of number of oscillation, for number of oscillation n, which is 15. So, for the inertia table alone, time t0 is equal to 55 and time period t is equal to t0 by n, where t0 is 55 and n is number of oscillation, which is 15. So, time period for inertia table alone is 3.3 seconds. So, when oscillations of block are taken about z-axis, then time period is 3.1. When oscillations are taken along x-axis, then time period is 3.3. When oscillations are taken about y-axis, then time period is 3.4 seconds. So, according to theorem of perpendicular axis of moment of inertia, tz square is equal to tx square plus ty square minus t0 square. So, tz square is equal to 3.3 square plus 3.4 square minus 3.1 square. So, tz is equal to 2.83. Hence, the theoretical value of tz is 2.83 and practical value of tz is 3.1, which are nearly equal to each other.
Hence, we have successfully performed the perpendicular axis theorem of moment of inertia with the help of this solid. You can perform this same experiment with the help of this cylinder and this solid. So, if you have any doubt regarding this experiment, you can refer to this solution manual. And if you are having further doubts, so you can contact to Tisca Technologies Jaipur. So, that's all about the experiment. Hope you like it.